हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 4 रेस्पिरेशन। आई हैव टॉट यू इन प्रीवियस क्लास दैट रेस्पिरेशन इन प्लांट्स एंड यू ऑल नो दैट ऑक्सीजन इज ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम द एटमोस्फियर थ्रू वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स, दैट इज थ्रू स्टोमेटा इन लीव्स, थ्रू लेंटिसेल्स इन स्टेम्स एंड थ्रू जनरल सर्फेस ऑफ द रूट्स। सो रेस्पिरेशन takes place through various parts of the plants, that is leaves, stems and roots. Today I will teach you basic process of respiration. Now, what is basic process of respiration? Children, you know that for respiration, organism need constant supply of oxygen, and that is provided by the process of breathing. Now, what is breathing? Breathing is a simple process of taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. So that taking in oxygen during inhalation step and giving out carbon dioxide during exhalation step is called breathing, and this is also known as external respiration. So why is it called external respiration? It's very simple. In this process of breathing, cells are not involved, only organs are involved, or you can say that this process of breathing takes place outside the cells. That is why it is called external respiration. Clear, children? Now, the second one is cellular respiration. What is cellular respiration? The process of respiration which releases energy takes place inside the cells of the body is known as cellular respiration. Now, why is it called cellular respiration? Because this process of respiration takes place inside the cells. That is why it is called cellular respiration, or this is also known as internal respiration. Breathing is known as external respiration and cellular respiration is known as internal respiration. Clear? Now, one important activity, activity 2 is given in your book, and it is about that exhaled air contains carbon dioxide. In previous activity, previous class, I had explained you one activity, that is activity 1. In that also I had told you that evolved air. Evolved means the air which is evolved during the process of respiration is rich in carbon dioxide. How we will prove this? It's very simple. For this, you have to take one apparatus. You can see here in your book, there are two test tubes. Test tube 1, here one capillary is inserted in this test tube. Both the test tubes are half filled by lime water, freshly lime water, and this is one capillary is inserted, is passed through this lime water, and here you can see this capillary is passed through lime water, and both the test tubes are closed by cork or rubber cork. The first test tube, this capillary is opened in the air, in atmospheric air. Here atmospheric air passes through this lime water which turns it milky, and in second test tube we will see exhaled air passes through this lime water which turns lime water more milky. This proves that exhaled air contains more carbon dioxide, or you can say that exhaled air is rich in carbon dioxide, and atmospheric air also contains carbon dioxide, but the concentration of carbon dioxide is more in exhaled air, which proves that exhaled air rich in carbon dioxide. Is it clear, children? Okay, now just look at the board. Now, in last class, children, I had taught you about word equation of respiration, and in this class I will explain you about chemical equation of respiration. You see here on the board that glucose, that is a six molecule of where six molecules of carbon is present,
So C6H12O6, that is glucose, plus 6 molecules of oxygen in presence of respiratory enzymes produce 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water vapor, and huge amount of energy is evolved, which is stored in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. Clear, children? So just see here, glucose plus oxygen in presence of enzymes give out carbon dioxide plus water vapor and energy. This energy is stored in the form of ATP. Clear? This entire process of respiration occurs in a step-by-step manner in the cell of the organism, or each and every cells of the living body. So this respiration is partially takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell, and it is completed in mitochondria of the cell. That is why this is called cellular respiration or internal respiration. Clear? Now I will teach you that differences between cellular respiration and breathing, internal respiration and breathing, or breathing is also known as external respiration. Now, what are the important differences between cellular respiration and breathing? Number one, it is an oxidative breakdown of glucose. What is oxidative breakdown of glucose? Here you can see in this equation, glucose is broken down by oxygen. That is why it is called oxidative breakdown of glucose. Number one point of breathing. Breathing is taking in of fresh air and giving out foul air. Okay. Now point number two, cellular respiration is known as, or it is called, biochemical process. Now, what is biochemical process? A chemical process. Respiration is a chemical process. A chemical process which takes place inside the living body or living organism is called biochemical process. Breathing is a simple physical process. Clear? Now, point number three, it produces energy and stores in the form of ATP. I have already explained that huge amount of energy is released during the process of cellular respiration or aerobic respiration, and it is stored in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. Clear? And in the process of breathing, breathing consumes energy. Breathing needs energy. Okay? Now, point number four, respiratory enzymes are involved. So this process of cellular respiration takes place in presence of various enzymes. That is why it is said that respiratory enzymes are involved, and breathing, no enzymes are involved. Clear? And the last point, that is point number five, it is an intracellular process. Why is it called intracellular process? Because I have already explained that this process of cellular respiration takes place inside the cells of the living body, or takes place in each and every cells of the living body. That is why it is called an intracellular process. And breathing is an extracellular process. Here, cells are not involved, only organs are involved. That is why it is called extracellular process. So these are some important differences between cellular respiration and breathing. So now, children, I think you all have understood that what is the chemical equation of respiration, what is the site of respiration, and what are the differences between cellular respiration and breathing. It's all for today, children. I will give you a few assignment questions that you have to do in your notebook. Okay, goodbye.